This is Bull Creek as it looks in September of 2011. It hasn't rained here in several months, and so the creek is completely dried out. And what I want to do today is I want to give you an idea of just how the drought is hitting us here in Texas. Well, this is Bull Creek. As you can see, things have changed quite a bit. Since the last video, there was a big, really big flash flood that came through, and it pushed the rocks like this one into the area here. This thing got pushed probably a couple of miles along the flat limestone and got deposited here. Then, after about a year, we got no rain for probably 9 months now. You may remember this rope swing from our last video where I was playing around in it. The water level here was about this deep. And you can see it's dry. Now this is over here, you see, is the area where the falls were coming over. And if you remember, we showed you a lot of ferns and stuff that were under the waterfall. Well, this is that cave here where those ferns and the moss is. And you can see that the ferns are all dried out. They're just bone dry. The moss has still got a little bit of green color to it. A lot of it's brown. Some of the stuff on the bottom is kind of falling apart, but up in here it's still tenaciously hanging in there. Down in the bottom there's a little puddle, and over here is another one, and there's still some little fish in there hanging on. So hopefully we get some rains pretty soon, this thing fills up, and they get a chance to spread out and breed a little bit. But this drought has really been hard here on Texas. There is a little bit of good news though. This main body of water is still here. And over in the center, it's still 4 or 5 feet deep. Right here, it's about a foot or so. And I'm seeing a lot of fish about that long. So they're still looking pretty healthy. I don't think I'd go swimming in the water right now. It's been kind of stagnant for a while. But it is clear, and they appear to be healthy. So hopefully in the next month or so, we'll get a little rain, rejuvenate this area, and they should come back okay. So that's a really good thing for me to see. I don't know whether you can see this or not, but there's still quite a few fish in here, and they're actually looking pretty healthy, all things considered. So that's a really good thing to see. And back over here, there's a deep channel. The water's still probably every bit of 4 or 5 feet deep, so they've got a place to go down and get out of the heat. And for these fish, that's very important. Well, I'm very glad to see that, at least in some spots, there's still enough water for the animals and to sustain fish life, even in the worst drought like this. So that's a very good thing. That's kind of comforting to me.
because I really expected to come here and find this whole thing just totally devoid of water. Now don't get me wrong, there are long stretches like this which have no water. You can see we're right on the river bottom. Nothing but limestone. But periodically you do run into pockets of water. So the animals that come down here, the deer, the rabbits, etc., there's still a place where they can get a drink. Plant life is still doing pretty well here. And once the rains come, it should get pretty much back to normal again. And that's a very good thing. I wanted to give you an idea of just what kind of energy a flash flood can have. Now, as I've stated, this area is bone dry right now. But if you look at these trees here, and look way up here, you'll see that there's stuff hanging in them. That's because that's how deep the water was during the flash flood. So that's pretty impressive. When I go over here and stand under that spot, that's about 18 feet above my head. So the water was coming through here with just tremendous amount of power.